He'll be okay, though.
You missed a tiny bit, not very much.
He'll be okay?
It was just,
he was talking about the bullets.
But, I had to fix
it. I don't extract every single scrap.
The game volume was louder than me.
He's liable to suffer some long-term toxicosis.
You could barely hear me. And it irritates me when I can't see.
Easy there. Try not to move.
Here we are. Taste the blood sounds nice, doesn't it?
We can't keep leaving this way, old boy.
Oh, God.
I figured I'd be done before you were conscious.
Swinehart, how bad is it?
Well, not the worst I've seen, but damn near it.
Yep.
I must say, you're testing even my skills here.
Please, Bigby, don't move.
Look, I'm a bit engaged setting his life at the moment. But if the fractured extremity concerns him that much, he can set it himself.
No, why are we doing this? Why are we doing this? Why? Oh no! Oh no! Ah! Oh, it's the bone, man. You don't know, you don't fuck with the bone. Ay, ay, ay. Yeah, keep on it. Pull it, pull. Ooh, this is so bad. Jeez, man, you should leave the doctor.
Not bad. That'll do, I suppose. He's lucky to be alive. And he won't be next time if he keeps going like this. He didn't listen to me before. Maybe he'll listen to you.
I don't know about that.
This is the job.
Quiet. Just relax.
Hey, jeez. You alright there, baby?
Excuse me, Miss White, but perhaps it'd be better if you gave me a few minutes to finish with him.
I think I should stay, at least until he's out of the woods.
Believe me, Bigby couldn't be in better hands, and I need the space to work, so...
I'll be fine.
Don't worry, Snow. I'll be okay.
We'll be done in a moment. Just please, give us the time.
Well, I'll give us time. We'll be fine. I promise.
Hey, Doc, how much longer?
Colin, leave him be.
It's finished when it's finished.
Because I once watched a vet sew a turtle together in 10 minutes flat.
Colin, you're not even supposed to be here right now.
Oh, really? Where am I supposed to be? I'm here to take care of my friend.
Colin, shut up.
Colin, shut the hell up, will you?
Yes, that would be helpful. There. Yeah. All done.
Great.
This isn't a habit you should keep to, having visits with me. And, well, this time was no joke.
But Doc,
eat as many metal
fine.
Shillings as you see fit, but take just one more silver round near your heart, and the only place I'll be visiting you is the morgue.
So no silver bullets.
Miss White.
Got it.
He'll be fine for light duty, if he can figure out what that means.
He knows what it means. It's just been an
no,
unusual
I don't know,
couple
like, duty.
Of days.
Tell
I
me
know,
what it means.
But please, don't give him the excuse.
I know what it is, but I'm not going to do it.
His body will eventually give out. Take care of him. Please.
I got it, Doc. I'll lay back with a cup of...
He'll need rest,
cup of Coke
I
and a
sleep most.
Big sandwich in front
just
of him.
Just keep watch. And make sure he doesn't get into further altercations.
I'm right here.
I'm right here, guys. Come on.
Anyways, guard against, as they say. Miss White, Sheriff, Colin.
Swiney.
Swiney. Bye. Bye, then. Namai. Leave me be. Is that beer?
So, how do you, feel?
It's Bigby, Snow. He'll be okay. Hell, I've seen him take worse.
As good as can be expected, I think.
So, not well then.
I'm glad you're not dead.
Ooh.
You stopped breathing, you know, when you passed out or died, I guess.
I died.
It... It kind of scared the hell out of me.
Ooh.
I've never seen you like that. And when Swinehart arrived, you know him, he's never worried. And even he thought you were... I don't know. It was just... awful.
Dun, 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 dun.
Yeah, you were really fucked up, man. You look like when you take an action figure and bend its limbs the wrong way.
Colin,
I'm just saying, I was worried about him is all. The guy hasn't had a night's rest in days.
We'll all get some rest when this whole thing is done.
What whole thing?
Sorry,
well, what's even happening out there? I mean, do you guys have like a plan or something? And who should I be asking? Should I be worried about the Crooked Man taking over?
Crane is still our focus. I just can't forget everything he's done. I don't care if he has problems with the Crooked Man.
Ichabod's gone. It's over for him. He's not coming back. It's
sorry,
not
my
about
dog
Crane
is all of a sudden
anymore,
playing
Bigby.
Moot, so if you hear more in the background than usually, I apologize.
Reason. For him to attack us so blatantly like that, he either feels invincible or desperate.
Well, if those are my two options, I don't think I'd pick desperate.
What do you mean?
You traded Crane to save Bigby. I'm just saying, that's not exactly something you do when you're playing with house
nice
money.
Yeah, thanks, Snow, for all that back there.
No problem.
Thanks? You're not pissed that Crane's flown the coop?
I hate that.
Or that the Crooked Man thinks he's got Snow under his thumb?
We're all mad about it, Colin.
You weren't there, Colin. So just drop it.
Okay, okay.
Thank you,
all
Colin.
All I care about right now is...
Colin's cool, but...
Just
geez,
what does the Crooked Man want out of this?
He does.
I thought he was just a loan shark, but clearly he's operating in other circles. It can't just be about Crane, right? Getting him out of town? Is this all about the murders? Crane can't be useful to him anymore. So what could this have to do with
Crane
Faith and
used.
Lily?
Crane was a puppet, and the Crooked Man worked the strings. This is all about control of Fabled Town.
Exactly.
But then what do prostitutes have to do with it? Lily? And Faith?
I don't know how it all works out yet, but I know it does.
Somehow.
The Crooked Man declared war against us last night. At least
fight,
that's what I thought when it happened. But
I'll
now
give my little
I see
one,
this
two.
War has been going on for years. We just haven't noticed it because our way of doing things is broken. We need to do things the right way.
What does that mean, the right way?
What do you think I mean?
I don't know, but it suspiciously sounds like your way. Bigby's the one on the front lines.
We're doing our best here.
I know things haven't gone great recently, but we're still doing our best.
Sorry,
that's not good enough.
Turning that down.
So, starting now, we do everything cut and dried, by the book, straight as an arrow.
Pure as driven snow.
I'm not saying I'm the arbiter of...
Sure you're not.
This town has enough monsters. What happened last night, what you turned into, it can't happen again.
We need monsters. To fight monsters.
Colin, if I really believed that we needed him to lose his flippin' mind at a moment's notice, then that would mean I'd lost all faith in our ability to help this town.
I'm sure from your vantage point, it's extraordinarily easy to judge me.
Bigby.
But you sit behind a desk all day. Only tonight did you see what it's like to be pushed into a corner all the time just for doing your job.
You think I don't know what it's like to have my life in danger? To not
what?
Push to do things? I know what it's like. And I know what it's like to lie to yourself. To justify what you've done. So don't talk to me like I'm other people. Look, Bigby, I care about how this is done just as much as I care about it getting done.
So for that, you want to give him a handicap? Like the bad guys will worry if shit gets sloppy. Everybody wants Bigby to smile and shave and take a shower now and then. Hell, I'm practically the president of the Bigby Don't Be Such a Dick Club. But this is the wrong fucking time to put shackles on him.
Relax, Colin. I can speak for myself, okay?
He'll get the job done. Just let him do it.
I'm going to let you do it, okay?
Thank you.
It's just that...
Just let me deal with it.
Now that I'm deputy mayor, I need your respect.
Got it.
And this situation has to end.
What situation?
All unglamored fables starting today have to go and stay at the
front. Give me a fucking break.
Uh-oh.
Are you gonna let her talk to me like that?
It's been the rule for
calm
a reason,
down,
Colin.
Look, everyone just calm down, alright?
I'm perfectly calm.
Oh, geez,
I'm not. Tell me right now, what's it gonna be, Bigby?
I don't know. Don't make me too wet. Don't know.
Wolf's residence.
That's rude.
Oh, Buffkin, what is it? Okay, I'll let him know. Thanks. Guess who's waiting in your office right now?
Who?
Narissa.
Narissa?
Narissa?
That broad from the pudding and pie?
Yes. Apparently, she told Buffkin that she has something she needs to talk to you about. But that she'll only tell you. And what do you think that could be?
Bigby's got an admirer. You always do well with the, disenfranchised.
She probably knows.
She knows something. She's helped me a little with the case. Maybe she has something else.
Maybe she does.
Hopefully.
I should get back to the business office. I've left Buffkin alone for too long taking calls.
Thank you.
And I should probably change out of these clothes.
Oh, believe me.
Consider the discussion tabled, but not over.
God damn it.
Let me know when you're done with Narissa.
Aye, aye, Captain. She's a piece of work. Hey, you're not really gonna send me to the farm, are you? I mean, she seemed real serious about it, but I can still hang out here, right? After everything we fucking been through, you don't have the nerve to give me a straight answer.
I can't. See, I can't say no, then I'll lie. If you actually do go. And if I say yes, then you still gonna be bad. It's a losing battle, okay? Just let me work my smarts, okay? Security office, B Wolf, Bigby Wolf. Hi there, Narissa. How are you doing? You have some business? Ah, goddammit. It's loading screens. Whatever these are. The credits. This is gonna be fun. Who's ready? Sorry. I make a lot of noises. Can't wait for my for everything to shush die down. Especially you back there. I hear you wagging your tail. You make the most noise.
It's all right.
I completely understand. Ah. These are cool. Cool little transactions. This looks like Well, no shit. I was gonna say it looks like New York, but they're in the Bronx, aren't they? Duh. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. Episode 4, In Sheep's Clothing.
Hi,
Bigby's office,
Sheriff.
The Woodland Building, morning.
Hi, Narissa.
Dog.
Have a seat.
Hi there, Narissa. How you doing? Nice office you got here, Bigby.
Are you okay?
I'm fine.
You didn't look good last night. I wasn't sure you'd be, you know, around.
I've been better.
Let's just say I've been better.
What? You cough and then you light a smoke.
Huff and puffs. Not many people smoke those.
Oh, sorry, you have Charlotte's? So what brings you here?
Thanks.
So what is it you wanted to talk to me about? I know what you did for me, sending me to the open arms. And I think you want to help me again.
There's not a lot that I can talk about. You know that.
So that spell Crane was trying to break. It's not just while you're at work, huh?
These lips are sealed, aren't you?
What I mean is, I don't want to waste your time, but I don't want you wasting your own time either.
Back in the dressing room, at the pudding and pie, I told you what I was looking for, and you found a way to tell me. You sent me to the open arms. Maybe that'll work again?
Hmm.
You can try. I just... Go ahead. It might work.
Crane wasn't the murderer. The open arms was a setup. And you sent me there. Was there someone else you wanted me to find there?
Hmm.
These lips are sealed. If I could answer you just like that, I wouldn't have had to make that appointment with you.
No, I guess not.
Hmm, alright.
Sometimes, we have to find our way through life on our own, grasping and fumbling in the dark.
So is it somebody in the dark?
I used to have friends to help me find my way, but now they're gone.
He's
and I don't know what
them.
To do. Ooh. Is this making any sense?
Are you saying you need a friend right now?
No, I
you can trust me.
What I'm saying is friends matter. And I don't have any left.
He's talking about there's a guy in the dark.
So I hope you're looking
his friend,
after
right?
yours.
That's what I'm connecting my head. Otherwise, I have
Are
no
you?
Idea.
Look around you.
Who are you talking about?
Are your friends
Are my
danger?
Friends in danger?
I'm sorry. I thought I could do this. I need you to know I want to help, but...
I hear you.
But...
It's okay. Take your time.
I'm sorry if I'm wasting your time. I thought I knew how to say it.
Ribbons.
Hmm.
Faith wore one too, huh?
Do you like it? Hmm?
It is beautiful. That's why you can't tell me anything. It's the ribbon, isn't it?
Ah, the ribbon. I'd never... God damn it. Take it off, maybe? That would probably help.
Can't we just take the ribbon off?
No! His lips are sealed!
What?
You can't! Just stay back!
Oh, whoa, what?
You can't do that!
Slow down. It's alright. I'm not gonna do anything.
Okay, calm down.
Please, don't.
Okay. Okay, we won't do anything.
Okay.
What the fuck is that about?
So the ribbons, if you take them off...
She dies? How? Anyways. Oh.
If anyone finds out I came here.
That's probably Snow.
With the smile.
Listen, Sheriff. Can you keep this conversation between us? I could be in a lot of trouble.
I won't tell anyone, don't worry.
Thank you.
Sorry,
I just need to talk to the sheriff for a moment. Please excuse us.
1 minute.
Sure thing. Come on.
I might have a new lead for you, but I don't know how solid it is. Beauty and Beast called the office just now. They said they wanted to talk to you about something. I wonder if they've heard about Crane.
Thank you for listening, Sheriff. You should go on to your next business. I don't think you'll be wasting your time.
Wait, you don't have to go.
So that means go. Okay. I'll go. You know
that
what you're talking
about.
That
was... abrupt?
It's one way to send a message.
What did she tell you? I didn't mean to rush her out. Did you get anything from her?
Don't worry. I handled it. She couldn't talk because of the magic, but we managed to understand each other.
I
did my job, my way. What did you expect?
Do you really want to know? Because you have given me reason to doubt you.
You have to trust me, Snow. And
trust.
I'm pretty sure she left convinced we're on the right track.
Mm-hmm. She knew.
Okay, then. Good work.
Thank you.
So, about Beauty and Beast, do you think there's something to it? Is this the right place to look? What could they know about the Crooked Man? Or do you think they just heard about last night?
That's what Narissa was doing, telling us to go there. I think she made it as clear as she could have.
Mm-hmm. Let's go.
Hmm. You know, Beauty came to me a while back.
Why did you just drop your cigarette? You put it back in your pocket.
She was looking for financial assistance. I told her there was nothing I could do, and she said that meant she'd have to go somewhere else.
Uh-oh. That means she has to move?
Bigby, you don't think she meant that she was going to go to the Crooked Man, do you?
That would explain why they called.
We need to solve this before something else happens. Who knows what?
I have other
matters to attend to.
So that means no, you're not coming with? Bye then. Jeez. I don't know why, but the loading screens take forever. Okay. Beauty and Beast's apartment, the Woodlands building. Woodland building.
And you didn't want to tell me what you were into either.
Good reason. Look what happened.
So that's back on me now. I thought we agreed that was settled.
You said it was settled. That doesn't...
Knock.
Hello? Someone here?
Oh.
Hi.
What do you want? Well, you're just going around knocking on doors?
Snow sent me.
Said you wanted to talk.
Not me.
Listen, I've had a shitty night.
Do you think you're the only one?
And I really don't want to deal with the runaround. Snow said you called and wanted to talk to me.
Well, I didn't call. Must have been Beauty. She's been surprising me a lot lately.
I know.
So have you, Bigby. Yet, with all the sneaking around and secrets, somehow I'm still the bad guy in this. I've had to hear about it all night long from her.
That's not way.
Who is it?
God damn it, Beast.
Who's there?
If you don't want to talk, can you just get Beauty for me?
I don't know. Is it safe to turn my back?
The fuck did I do?
Thank you.
It's your pal, Bigby.
Hi, Bigby. Please excuse us for just a minute. Can I talk to you in private?
Yes, let's.
God damn it.
I guess I really do have the smallest apartment in the Woodlands.
I can already tell you're going to make a problem out of this.
Yeah, you do.
What's he doing here? We don't need to bring him into this.
Beast.
I just don't think we can trust him. Not after the way he went behind my back.
Trust me, what the fuck
and
did I...
You what did what? Call him again?
Well, I trust him.
Of course you do. He was keeping secrets.
Shit over. Jeez.
Talk about living in the past.
Do you want to keep fighting about that? Or do you want to try to sort this out?
All I'm saying is we can handle this on our own. You didn't have to bring him here.
You're out of money. And answers. That's why I called.
What else am I looking at?
We'll finish this later. Oh, we need to talk to Bigby.
Fine. If you want to talk, we'll talk.
Alright. Does that mean you're coming out? There we go.
Sorry, it's been a long night.
Yeah,
I understand.
You know what so they say. Centuries of marriage come with centuries of baggage.
I gotta say, your place, it looks, expensive.
What do you mean by that?
That's nice.
Beast!
No, really, I want to know. What are you trying to say,
nice.
Huh?
That's all.
Nothing. It's a nice place you got here.
Thanks, but that's really not why I called.
Is this something about
that's
that
fine.
Loan you took
Jeez,
out?
Beast.
From the crooked man?
I didn't know what else to do, so...
We should deal with this on our own. Bigby's just going to complicate
God damn,
I
Beast,
called him here, and I want to see if he can help us out. Why are you being like this?
I'm just trying to do what's best for us.
I want to
I'd
help
like
you.
To help you, but I can't do anything if you don't tell me what's going on.
I gotta know one thing first. What if we did have something to say about the Crooked Man? What if we talk and you don't get him? And all this comes back on us? We'd be risking a lot. We've seen what happens when you cross the Crooked Man. And I don't know if it's worth it. If you can't give us certain assurances.
If you're...
I can protect you, but only if you tell me what I need to know. And that means details. No more stonewalling.
Thank
we
you.
Aren't.
And just tell me what's going on here.
Look, we're used to a certain kind of lifestyle, okay? We couldn't just give that
we
up.
We never meant for it to get like this. It's just that we had nowhere else to turn. And we got in over our heads.
There's not a lot of work out there. Who would we be if we just lived like...
Who's calling?
Hi there, you've reached Beauty.
And Beast.
And we're out doing something fabulous.
Let me just...
What the fuck?
A day at the beach?
Hey.
Skiing afloat?
You're not done here.
I should...
And we can't come to the phone right now, so leave a message at the beep and we'll get back to you as soon as... humanly possible.
Beep!
That fucking message. I'm gonna come down there and bash your heads in with that machine if I have to call again and hear that fucking message one more time.
Huh?
I've been doing this long enough to know that if you had the cash, you'd have paid by now. So consider yourselves out of warnings. It's time to start thinking about how else you can settle this.
Who is that?
The Crooked Man's gonna get his, one way or another.
A Crooked Man. Who is that?
All I care about is, how can I find the Crooked Man? Who do I talk to? Where do I go?
If you told me I can, you know, end this shit.
The Lucky Pawn. That's where I borrowed the money. The Crooked Man's
pawn.
Behind that place. I'd overheard people talking to Jersey about loans before.
Sorry.
So, when I needed money, that's where I went. I didn't know what to do.
You could have told
Wait,
me.
Who's Jersey?
Wait, who do you deal with?
Jersey. You know, the Jersey Devil.
Oh, yeah.
God damn it.
That slimy prick. I didn't realize he was back on this side of the river.
And those Tweedles were always going in and out. Probably dropping off a loan payment they squeezed out of some poor fable. But never the Crooked Man. Mainly it's just regular fables.
Dumbers.
I can see now that it was a mistake,
I killed one of them, so was it D or
I'm not the only one who goes there, you know. I saw the woodsman's axe there just the other day.
Should kill
D. It was in a display case.
Should still have dumb.
I guess he's hit hard.
Come on, man. fucking apologize for that.
At hard times, too. There's a lot of that going around. I can't imagine he has a lot of marketable skills.
Fucking Bloody Mary must go through there. She had Woody's axe last night, trying to chop my damn head off with it.
Maybe if you go there, you can sort some things out.
Hopefully. I guess I'll go check out the Lucky Pawn. If I can't track down the Crooked Man there, maybe I can make enough noise that the Crooked Man will come find me.
Hold on, Bigby. Don't go there.
It's smart.
Sounds like you're just going to get Beauty in trouble. And...
it's...
you know that butcher shop? The Cut Above?
Mm-hmm.
It's the place on Tubman Street. Same block as the baker and the candlestick.
Picture.
Well, I've been delivering packages from there for a while. The thing is, it's for the Crooked Man.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't think it's meat in the packages. You gotta understand, I needed work.
You have to believe us. We didn't think it would get like this.
You're telling me that with a place like this, you're so hard up that you need to work for the Crooked Man? The guy you're so afraid of? Bullshit.
It's not like he runs the counter and hands me the boxes. I never met the guy.
How did you get involved with this?
Johann the Butcher called. He had a problem with the refrigeration unit one night. But when I finished, it was your pal Mary who showed up to pay me. She said I was reliable. She liked that. And it's the only thing I've been able to pick up. And it's still not enough. I don't want Beauty to have to work, especially not where she was. It's up to me to take care of her.
Is Mary all the way there?
Bloody Mary is there?
No, Johann is the one who hands over the packages, you know, day to day. But I've seen her around there. She gets under my skin, you know? I try to avoid her. But I don't need to tell you what she's like.
You're damn right you don't. I don't need a rundown on her reputation. If Mary works out of there... I need to look into it.
I just wanted to provide for Beauty. Give her the kind of life she deserves.
We shouldn't have to live like this. Scraping to get by.
None of us should.
I understand.
We were royalty once. We were accustomed to a certain lifestyle. All we want is to make this place feel a little bit like home. You wouldn't understand, Bigby.
I don't know.
I don't need to understand. It's not my fucking job to understand. My job is to keep Fable Town safe.
So, where are you going? If this all goes sideways, I'd like to know where it's coming from.
Is this one of those choices again? I can go either here or here. Butcher shop or Lucky Pawn? Lucky Pawn.
I'm going to the Lucky Pawn. There's too much going on there to ignore. I'll have a word or two with Jersey.
You know, Bigby, once you show your face there, word is going to get out. There may be nothing left to see if you go to the butcher shop after.
Well, I guess I'll find out.
Wait. I don't know what you're planning to do when you find the Crooked Man, but... is there any way you could help us out?
Like what, money?
Well, maybe you can make this all just go away.
We would really appreciate it. What do you say?
Can you help us out?
I'll handle it. I'm not gonna let that crooked bastard ruin any more lives.
Oh, thank you, Bigby.
I'm sure you'll do the right thing.
We will. We will. We will. Definitely. Alright. Let's go talk to Jersey. Go kick his ass. I don't even know what he... is he a bad guy or is he a good guy? Is he gonna help me or is he bad? So far what they're saying, they're bad, so... I'm gonna keep that as bad. Lucky Pawn, jewelry repair, antiques, batteries.
It's dirty.
No, it's not.
It looks like you slept in it.
Frog.
In a pile of garbage.
Jack, why are you... I've seen you take a torn purse for a tenner.
Yeah, but I also got her phone number. I don't want your phone number. Ugh, really?
Whoa.
Yeah, hi.
Bigby's here.
Oh, why are you never glamored, Toad? Why is it so hard to just follow the rules?
Look, I know some fables can switch from man to beast and back again, like changing shirts. But it's not so easy for the rest of us to look human, all right? And anyways, I'm getting the money right now.
I'm not taking the coat.
But it's magic!
So?
And it'd be covering a check I already wrote.
Okay, well, that sounds like a your problem to me.
Yeah, it is. And so I came here to sell it off.
Can we
move this along?
I'm trying to, but this lousy git can't see a good deal even when it walks in on two little legs. So what's it gonna be?
I don't know what to tell you. See if Cindy needs a coat. I don't know.
This is to pay for those bloody glamours, you know. You and your blinkered rules. If a witches didn't charge so fucking much...
You know, maybe Snow can help you out.
How could Snow help me out?
Give you an advance. A loan or something. She's kind of in charge of the business office now.
Well, the last guy who was in charge didn't help us much. So forgive me if I don't expect anything different now.
Okay.
I don't know what you're getting so steamed about. Shouldn't be that big of a shock that I'm not going to take an ass hair coat.
No, I guess it shouldn't be, since this whole bleeding operation's just a setup for one of his shady fucking loans.
Ixnay on the onlays, okay, Og Frey?
I mean, what kind of a game are you running here?
Toad?
You turn down people's stuff so you can peddle his shit?
It's not worth it, Toad.
What? Sometimes it's worth it? You know, depending.
No.
I mean, I don't even know what he's talking about.
When has a crooked man loan ever been worth it, Jack?
Well, I'll leave you to your business. I'm sure you'll have a lot to talk about.
Good luck with that glamour, Toad.
Fuck off.
Leave the coat.
How the hell do you expect me to get a glamour, then? It's not like I've got a lot of options, you know.
Give Toad the glamour.
Look, I'll give you some money, all right?
You've got to be kidding me.
Do you even know how much a glamour costs?
I've never had to buy one.
Keep your money, Sheriff. I've no patience for charity.
Well, then fine. Don't bitch
at me. If you're gonna be out like this, can't you at least wear a bigger hat?
You know, it's getting old to tell the difference.
Between what?
Between the business office and fables like a crooked man, who you purportedly seek to protect us from. Either way, I'm getting screwed.
Drop by anytime.
I'm trying to work on it.
Look, I'm sorry, all right? What else do you want from me?
He really grows on you.
Jack, shut the fuck up.
Look, I work here sometimes for the extra cash. It's something stable. Mm-hmm. You know, between more entrepreneurial bouts. And before you ask, I've never seen the crooked man in here. Neither hide nor hair and all that. In fact, as far as I can tell, he's never even actually stepped foot in here.
But Bloody Mary works for him. And the last time I saw her, she had the woodsman's axe.
So?
Yeah,
so the last time anybody else saw that axe, it was here.
We'd never take something like that. Is this really why you came down here?
I mean,
the woodsman's axe?
I could kick your ass.
Because I don't know anything about it.
I'll be asking the questions here, Jack.
Okay, fine. Fire away.
Where's the manager? Why isn't he here?
Maybe I'm the manager. You ever think of that?
I know you aren't. So where is he?
I don't know. I don't keep tabs on him.
Wait,
eating cows right now.
Probably. No. That knife on the... whatever thing falls. The knife in the display case.
Listen,
it was a knife
that stabbed. Closing up shop. So
close.
Yeah,
it's the middle of the day.
What can I say?
What,
Jersey
husband.
Likes to run it odd hours, and really, he'd be the one to talk to. So can't you just swing by later?
No,
it wouldn't be good for me if he sees your face when he walks in.
Tell
so
me
what else Jersey. Can you tell me about Jersey Devil?
Just that he's a fucking psycho, and I like to stay out of his way.
Mm-hmm,
I typically work when he's not here. But I can call you when he comes back, all right? Can't you
shut up, Jack. If the Jersey Devil isn't here to answer my question,
shut up,
also
Jack.
Means he isn't here to get in my way. So I'm going to take a look around. As long as I've got the elbow room.
All right. Don't let me get in your way.
Oh, well. The anvil.
What's the anvil for?
Blacksmith didn't need it.
Haven't seen him around for a while.
Ooh.
The headless horseman. Isn't this Crane's?
Maybe. I don't know.
Yes. Fucking. The dagger.
This is Prince Lawrence's dagger. Who sold this?
They stole that one.
I don't know.
Look, are you almost done? A dagger isn't exactly the axe, so,
goddamn, Giles, slam your head into the back of that wall.
Whoever did it must have needed the money bad, which shouldn't come as a total shock. You don't know how hard most of us have it, do you?
No.
I know what it's like.
I know how it is.
It was a rhetorical question, but sure, fine.
What? Sure sound like it. Trophy. The axe of the woodsman.
I thought you said you'd never take something like this.
What?
You're a lying
piece of shit, Jack.
Okay, come on, Bigby. That wasn't...
The axe was right here all along. Now tell me what happened to it.
I don't know anything about that. I don't, really. I mean, I don't work every day, so... And even when I do work, I just try to keep my head down.
Just tell me the truth. What happened to the axe?
It was Mary. She took it, okay? That's all I know.
That's all you know? You don't know she almost fucking killed me with it last night?
No. No. I had no goddamn idea.
Why did she take it? Just to fuck with me?
You think I'm crazy enough to ask her that? I'm not sticking my foot in that lawnmower, thank you.
Well, for your sake, you better think of something to tell me.
That's all I can tell you. I'm being straight here. I'm just part-time. I mean, it's Jersey who's the one who's into this stuff. He's one of the Crooked Man's boys, okay? And it'd be great if he was here to tell you all this, but he's not. So just...
Jersey, don't give me that shit. What the fuck is the point of having a system if you're just gonna...
my fucking system?
The woodsman.
But you're the guy who makes sure
I'm the guy to keep shit in order, and that's it, Woody. Who closed the fucking gate?
Boom.
Jack? If you love your ex so fucking much, why'd you pawn it in the first fucking place, huh?
I didn't pawn it, asshole. It was stolen from my apartment. And Gren said that he saw it here. Now tell me where it is right now.
Hiya, fellas.
Christ. And this fucking guy, too?
Bigby?
Is his axe even here?
Nope. It isn't.
Just like I said, it's not here. Happy? And you? I can't believe you'd even show your face in here. After
or
what
you
did to our guy, Tweedledum?
Oh, I killed Tweedledum.
So tell me what you're here
Sorry.
For, or get the fuck out.
He wanted to know where...
Actually, you
I got
know
some
what?
Questions
I don't care what he wanted.
You work with the Crooked Man. And until I give you permission, you're not gonna do anything but answer my questions.
How's your arm? Bloody Mary leaves a bit of a stink, don't she? Jack. Did you know that as of this very morning, Bigby's joined the Crooked Man's Obedience School for wayward fucking creatures? He's already passed his first class. You see, the sheriff had who he stupidly thought was the murderer.
Very funny.
Been chasing him for fucking days, right? But the Crooked Man snapped his bony fingers, and Bigby handed him over just like that.
I'm, just gonna...
let you two, you know...
Go fuck yourself, Jersey.
Goodbye, Jack. See you later. Yeah, the axe was here. Hang on now. Are you gonna get mad? Are you gonna start fighting him?
Are you kidding me? It was here. It was right fucking here. What did you do with it?
How the fuck do I know?
Listen, you bald little dipshit. You're gonna... You piece of shit!
Ooh.
I'm gonna rip your fucking lungs out!
Pull it, Woody.
We don't need the business office involved in this shit. I just want
just
what's
go
mine.
Home, Woody.
My axe.
Will you get out of here?
go home.
Not until this fucker gives me my axe. Where's my axe? Who'd you give it to?
Damn. Stop fighting for a fucking second.
This
Jesus
is my
Christ.
Fucking fight.
Not now.
Dog, you got a lot of nerve.
That was hard to. I almost missed that one. Ooh, it's getting busted. Woohoo! Shit's going down.
There she is.
Hold it. Block him. Blacker. Good fuck. Leave me alone. Ooh, dude, man, you're going bloody shit. You ripped off his horn and stuck it in his chest. What's wrong with you? My arm that I just fixed. Fucking dead. Go.
Hey assholes, I found her.
Right up there, man. Yikes. Dude, that axe is so badass.
Wanna try again?
You can't find a crooked man. No one can. There's no address, no place. He lives in the bends and forks of tree roots, behind the sun, in the shadows.
That's not good enough.
Oh, the door to his house. It bounces around. Never in one spot. You'll never find it. Even Crane had to use the magic mirror. That fucking guy. Oh, mirror.
How
mirror.
Did you?
Okay, that's
him.
Crane's way. How do you contact him?
Oh, I don't. He uses couriers for everything. Ravens, oh, goblins, the fucking Tweedles. Whatever. I go in when I'm taken there. You don't know anything about anything, do you? What do you have? Nothing. That useless bitch Snow White in a broken fucking mirror. No fucking friends. No clue about who is really running this town.
Nothing? I still have you, don't I?
It doesn't matter what you fucking do. You're not gonna get him. You wanna knock on his fucking door and see what happens? Fine. Crane had the mirror. Bloody Mary had Crane.
Crane.
So take your fucking wrecking crew act to the butcher shop.
The cut above. And if I can find the mirror piece there, I can find the crooked man.
That's her spot. That's where all the magic happens.
Good job, Woody.
Now leave me. So I can find some aspirin. Oh.
He ain't going anywhere.
You better not be fucking with me, or I'll come back here and finish the job.
You got what you want. Now get the fuck out of here.
Tell me whenever you wanna. I mean, I could find some aspirin for you.
Hey, Sheriff. Those girls are still dead. Oh, and there's nothing you can do to bring them back. And I don't know what they did, but I do know this. Oh, if they're dead, it's because the Crooked Man wanted them dead. That's all it takes.
Shut the fuck up.
Jesus Christ. Kick him right in the face. Kicked him so hard.
Smoke.
Fucking bounced off the ground. Jesus. Dun 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 dun.
Thanks. Shitty brand.
You're welcome.
I'm not Jesus. Gonna lie. I was having trouble deciding which one of you to hit with this thing.
Thanks for choosing me. I appreciate it
Jersey
dearly.
Was wrong, you know.
About what?
About those girls. There is something you can do about it. You can get the fucker who did it. Ain't that the plan?
It's my job. I'll get him.
All right. I'll go do it then.
It's exactly what I am doing. See you around, Woody.
Hey, Woody.
Yeah.
See you around, all right?
Yeah. I'll see ya.
So we can be friends with Woody. Woody's cool. Oh, I mean, what he did in the first episode wasn't that cool, but you know, shit gets done when shit gets done. The Cut Above Butcher Shop, Tubman Street. Stop smoking. Out of respect. Respect. Oh, you just leave it on the fucking ground. Meat. Some sausages, some sirloin steaks.
Not very appetizing.
No, they don't look
appetizing. Solid. Who'd want to eat this? I don't see these cuts anywhere in here.
Cold drinks, there's cola, lemon, lime. That's supposed to be like Coca-Cola and Sprite.
Empty. Either he's got a whole lot of customers, or he doesn't have any.
Either way.
Right.
Yep. We support NYPD. Ding. Ding. Hello, Butcher.
Bigby Wolf? What happened to you?
I'm looking for a piece of the magic mirror.
What?
The magic mirror's missing shard. Where is it? Bloody Mary brought it here, didn't she?
What?
I would like it, please.
Bloody Mary? Magic mirror shard? What kind of place do you think this is?
Don't bullshit me.
I'm not.
There's a lot of bullshitting.
What you're looking for, I think you'd be better off looking at the Lucky Pond.
Yeah,
or someplace like that.
You know where it is, right?
It's around the corner and a few blocks down.
I'm gonna take a look around. You don't mind.
Sheriff, I...
Hmm?
Did you hear that?
What?
Oh, I'm real sorry.
You son of a bitch.
Hold on. I just gotta go check on that. Don't go anywhere. I'll be right back.
No, you son of a bitch.
I just
have
to go see.
I saw that. You pressed that button, you son of a bitch.
Shit.
Do I have to treat you like the other fuck back there? I wasn't really expecting to actually beat up that guy. Shit got into a bind. Whoops. I don't see shit.
Okay, I've had enough of this shit, Johan. Come on out.
Just wait in the front. I'll be right out. I'm sorry, Sheriff, but you're not supposed to be back here for safety purposes.
Mm-hmm. Always gotta be hiding shit from me. Don't you understand that I'm trying to help y'all? Give me the mirror shard.
Just give me the magic mirror shard and I'll leave you alone. And you can go back to whatever it is you're doing here.
Be a lot easier. Shit, it's stupid shit.
They're gonna kill me. Oh god, she is gonna fucking kill me.
Are you ready to listen?
He's gonna get me killed.
Huh? Hiya.
How you doing?
How you doing?
Please,
please, pick
me. Please,
stop.
What happened to
the
sheriff?
Please, don't kill me, sheriff. I don't want to die. Please. Please
talk
don't
or else.
If you don't talk, I might have to do just that. Is that what you want, Johan?
No, no, please. You don't have to do that. I'm dead. Either way. They said to me, Johan, you could keep your life and lose your shop, or lose both. What would you do? It was a simple choice to make in the moment.
I'll deal
easy
with what's
even
behind
when they got
the door.
To work in the deep freeze.
Just open the door, Johan, and it won't be your problem anymore.
I can't.
Why not? What's back there?
I don't know.
Tell me.
I've never been back there. It's locked from the other side. Look. I just worked the front. That's all I'm supposed
bullshit.
To do.
So you are a part of this. You've been bullshitting me this whole time. I've already asked you, and I don't like repeating myself. Where's the mirror shard?
We
so help me, I will
sex.
Put your head through that damn door. Tell me what I need to know, now.
I don't know. I'm not part of their crew.
Crew?
The Crooked Men's people. Jersey Devil, D and Dumb, and that
go
mental
on.
Case Bloody Mary. You want to talk about the real butcher? It's her, not me. This is her place. I'm telling you, they muscled in on me, took over my storage and delivery a long time ago. All because of that heat wave. That summer was even hotter than this one. Oh, I'd let Mary and those porkers stay cool in the meat locker one day, playing cards, having a great time. I guess they were sizing the place up. Shows what I get for being nice.
No,
I'm just a victim in this. I don't know what they do back there. I swear. And I don't want to know.
Victim?
Well, we're about to see what's back there. And then we'll see if I believe you.
I knew this would happen. Didn't know when.
Mm-hmm. Open. 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 Go. Bye. Oh, broke the locks. Wait, if you locked it on the inside, how do you get inside? Because you got out and locked on the... How did you even lock it from the inside? Or from the outside, I should say. What the fuck? That's the button you pressed. You son of a bitch, you did know. It was slaves.
What is this place?
I told you, Bigby. I don't know. They muscled me out. I swear, I don't know anything more. I haven't been back here when it was like this.
Warning lights.
It's business. It's all I've ever had. I guess that's why I stuck around when they took it.
These lights, Johan. Did you warn them I was here?
I had to. You come in here making trouble for me. But you only give a shit now because the crooked man stepped on your toes or something. Where were you when they took this place from me? It hasn't been easy for me. You think I want to live with this at my back? I needed help.
Sit down, Johan.
Do me a favor. Just shut the fuck up and stay out of the way. Can you manage that?
I'm tired of this. Where were you when you helped me here? Where were you when you helped me here? Glamours.
So this is what Beast was delivering. Glamours. Other kinds of magic. Could be dangerous stuff.
Maybe just don't touch anything back here, please?
Didn't I tell you to sit down and shut up?
Chemistry lab.
What are they making?
A piece of potions.
I'm just a butcher. You want to talk T-bones? That I can do. This stuff is out of my league.
There are a lot of nasty spells you can make with the right equipment.
Aiden. Shackle.
James. Who's getting chained up here?
You can't think I'm the only one the crooked man has under his yoke.
Alright.
Is this what those loans get you? That crooked piece of shit. Ribbons. Chains. It's all the fucking same.
So the crooked man's behind everything.
These are raw materials for making magic. Anti-Greenleaf and any other rogue witches out there probably get their supplies here.
Anti-Greenleaf, you sumbitch. Are you still making that shit after I came in there and knocked you out?
Too bad they had time to erase it all. This could have been useful.
Oh, it's lads. Damn it. Son of a bitch.
That's simple. It's on all the packages. What is it?
That's the Crooked Man's
brand.
It's on everything that goes in and out of here.
So and
you
it's a
do
puppet,
know
right?
something, huh? Is that a wheel or what?
I guess they never used that thing on wolves, huh?
What's that supposed to mean?
It's from back in the homelands. A torture device. It came over here with the rest of our stories. Not that Bundys need any help coming up with that kind of thing. It makes people crooked. By breaking their bones and... Do I really need to explain this?
No, I got it.
What the hell is that?
That's a jacket. It looks like Crane's. Crane's purple jacket. Well, pick it up.
I know this isn't your coat. What's it doing here?
It's a coat. What's the big deal about some dirty...
Looks like Crane's. It's seen some abuse. I'm sure he handled it just fine.
The pocket. What's in here?
No time for traveler's checks, huh?
Money!
He won't be needing this anymore.
Thank you. Look in this pocket.
That sick piece of...
Again with the picture. God damn it. I'm gonna kick his ass.
The shard. It's the shard. Finally.
Hey, hold on. Well,
what?
I'm real happy you found what you're looking for, Bigby. But what about me?
Huh?
What the hell am I supposed to do now?
I don't know, you
I'm
just
gonna
lied
have to
me.
Spend the rest of my short life looking over my shoulder for Bloody Mary. They won't care that I held
we'll
up
find
my
a
end.
Way to
report to the
you.
Business office. Tell Snow I sent you there, and we'll figure something out. Some kind of protection.
Thank you, Sheriff.
Mm-hmm. No thing. Now, get out of my sight. Kick your ass, lad, Navy.
What are?
Sorry, we're closed. Dun 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 dun.
Woo!
What are we doing now? Got rid of most of everything, now what are we doing? So, we finally got the shard. We have to go put it back inside the mirror and see where the Crooked Man's entrance is. Right? Last time I checked, that's what we're doing.
I don't care who killed the prostitutes. If Crane was helping himself to the community coffers, it means his hand was in my pocket. And you just let him go!
I don't know what you heard, but it didn't happen like that.
Are you denying the facts?
She's denying me the chance to get a word in. Now, Miss White,
Sheriff Bigby has returned.
Ah, there's the old wrecking ball himself.
Bigby, where have you been?
I'm not finished here, Miss White.
You will have to wait. Just one moment,
thank you.
Please.
Look what I found.
The shard.
Seems your dog wants a biscuit.
I'm not in the mood. And you've got a lot to answer for.
Oh, really?
Bufkin, get this piece in the mirror right away.
With pleasure, Miss White.
Thank you, Bufkin.
Finally, things are swinging back in the right direction. Good work, Bigby. You've been gone all day. What did you uncover? I thought you were going to report back to me. I mean, it's fine. So what else did you find out?
Once the mirror's fixed, we can use it to find that crooked bastard. Or at least wherever he hangs his hat. That's how Crane kept tabs on him. And everybody else. I'd say he was abusing the privilege. He was probably spying on all of us.
He was probably spying on me.
Anyway.
Yeah. No, it's fine. You did excellent work, Bigby.
Sheriff, I could use your assistance. Would you join me at the mirror?
Yeah. Okay.
Don't go far, Sheriff. I'd like to have a few words of my own with you.
Unbelievable.
Oh, take a number.
Take a number.
I don't understand. This piece just doesn't want to join the rest. Do you have any idea why?
Got me.
Well, where did you find it? What has it gone through since being separated from the rest? Shattering is a very traumatic experience, you know. So this process can be a little touchy.
Crane was carrying it for part of the night, at least. I found it in his coat. It's pretty amazing it's still intact after the fight, the kidnapping, and then riding around with Bloody Mary for however.
Yes, Miss White was asking about her. That explains it. You know who and the mirror have a very unhappy history with each other. How would you like it if she tried to use you as a doorway?
I think I already know the feeling.
Well, I think I know how to proceed now. It will just take a little extra coaxing, that's all. Thank you for your help. It could be a while, Sheriff. I'll find you when it's ready. Besides which, he might not want to come out with you watching.
Oh, he doesn't like being spied on.
Is it fixed? Did you ask about the Crooked Man?
Bufkin's still working on it. He said it might be a while.
If you're so self-reliant, what do you want from the business office so bad?
What I want is my business.
I can't take those two right now.
Neither can
We're
I. I've been
to
here
catch
for
a murderer,
what,
and they're
3 minutes now, and they've just
they're
been
over there
my ear?
Bickering about bureaucracy. We're at war. Don't they realize that?
You need some help over there.
Yeah, thanks. Go talk to Toad. But just so you know,
shut up.
We
you
can't
out.
Pay
you. You shut up. I'll pay you. You shut up.
He really
you
needs
go
to go
home.
To the farm, you know. So, just break the news and be done with it, okay?
I can't, but he's got... Should I be nice
Toad,
to Toad?
Come here.
I
thought I made
myself very clear. I see how it is. Passed off to an underling, eh?
Why am I not surprised?
Well, you did cause what damage brings me in here, so maybe it's for the best. Just need a little bit of dosh to cover it. I tried talking to her about it, but it's like chatting up a brick wall, it is.
Okay.
Now, I'm sure you've got your own agenda, Sheriff, but I've taken a real wallop because of you.
I'm starting to think you don't take me seriously, Toad. How many times have I told you to get glamored up? You know that if you're out of glamour, I gotta send you to the farm.
Well, how about your friend the pig, hmm? Is he going to the farm too?
Yeah, you thought we didn't know about him, huh? A worst-kept secret in Fable Town. For a friend, the rules are bent.
I haven't decided on him yet, but every situation's different, Toad.
Well, might I suggest a path of compassion for the pig? And me boy, too. If you give me one more chance and hear me out, I'll see a way for me and me boy to stay. I'm not gonna ask for any more than I need. I just wanna stay. So what do you say? You just give me enough to cover me glamours and we'll call the rest a wash. Please, Sheriff, don't take TJ from the only army knows. This old glamour rules. Oppressive. I've done nothing wrong but look different. You know it's not right. Burdening the weakest of us like this.
Look, I'll try to get you that money and get you another chance, but you have to understand, that's not entirely up to me.
Oh, thank you, Sheriff. I knew I could count on you to make me whole again. We get it sorted, and I'll be glamour to the nines, I will.
I will try. That doesn't mean... Son of a bitch.
Bluebeard, you want to talk? Now's your chance.
I've just made my donation funding this office, so direct your questions to Miss White.
Well, at least he's not trying to get rid of me.
He's not?
For now. Did you take care of Toad? I mean, I saw the way he left. I know it may not seem that important right now, but glamours are the law for a very good reason. You know that as well as anyone.
Don't worry.
I did the right thing.
I did the right thing.
Are you sure? Because he left looking pretty happy.
Can we please just...
Fine. We'll deal with it later. I know I should be asking how it got like this, but I just keep wondering why it happened to Faith and Lily. You've seen his world. Do you have any idea why he'd want them dead? I don't know if the Crooked Man killed them with
his
own hand
control.
Or if it was one of his goons.
They want it.
If there's one thing I figured out, it's that the Crooked Man is all about control. It's what he does with the loans at the pawn shop. The magic he peddles. Chains. Ribbons. Maybe Faith and Lily weren't doing what they were told. Or maybe they just tried to leave.
Sheriff! Miss White! I believe the mirror is repaired.
Thank you, Buffkin.
I have to say, I have been better. But thanks for putting me back together.
I'm sorry, I have to know. Mirror, mirror, we're glad you weren't slain. Now please show us that sick creep Crane.
Just keep it silent.
He's probably still waking up a little.
You will get on that plane to Paris, and you will wait for the day the Crooked Man needs you. Until then, not a peep. Otherwise, I get to deal with you my way. So please, please disobey. Wait a minute. Someone's watching.
You son of a bitch.
Just... happened.
We pointed you in the wrong direction and looked at Bloody Mary's reflection.
Oh, her. That explains the sting. I'd rather not have to feel the pain she brings.
I can understand.
Let's not do that again, okay?
Looks like we'll have to track him down later.
You're right. We need to focus on the immediate threat, and that's the Crooked Man. Bigby, we don't have a lot of time.
Mirror, mirror, no time to pout. So where does Crooked Man hang out?
That is hard to say.
I don't recognize the door, but that's the Crooked Man symbol on it.
Hold on.
It just moved. That's the back alley of the pudding
pie. It moves.
Yeah, Jersey mentioned that.
Wait a minute. I know that door.
So
that's
do I.
Central Park. I don't know when it's gonna move again, but I'm gonna get there before it does.
Bigby, wait. When you get the Crooked Man, make sure you bring him back alive. He has to stand trial. This can't be like it was with Tweedledum. I don't care if it gets out of hand. You don't let it come to that. I know that emotions can run high, and you have your reasons to handle this a certain way.
I can't make that promise. This could turn sour, just depending on how the wind blows. I have to be able to handle it how I see fit.
If people are going to have faith in the Fabletown government again, we need to be fair. Show them that we're doing things the right way. I have enough to worry about here while I prepare the case against
him. Cut his neck open.
So I'm going to trust you to handle this properly. That is, if you think you're ready.
Of course I'm ready. I got no other choice.
I'm ready. Promotion. I'm ready. Promotion. Fuck.
Woo!
This is gonna be fun. Dun, 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 dun. Okay, we actually doing really good this time. Didn't say anything bad. The beginning started off really crucial. The Gothic Bridge, Central Park, 94th Street. There's the door, Bigby, open it up. Kick it.
Woohoo!
Some weird magic. Keep going. That'd be actually kind of cool of a door, just to, like, if you wanted to go in your room and it's just never there, it's just never pointed in direction. You just had to walk through a door and ran over there.
Tim, what the hell are you doing here?
Good evening, Hi, Sheriff. Tim. I'm here to take you to the boss. Thanks, by the way, for leaving off Tiny.
Tiny Tim.
I have to admit, when they asked me to watch the door, I wasn't sure what to expect when you came through that portal. I know you aren't here on a social call.
What is this place? Or where is it? I know I'm not in Central Park anymore.
I'm not sure. I've only ever come in through one of the portals. I don't think you can get in from the actual street. But you can't blame him for wanting to make it hard to find.
Yeah, I see what you mean.
I'm supposed to bring you right on in, so if you'll come this way. Look, this is the one thing I have to do.
Fine, lead on.
This is actually kind of cool. Dean Smoyle.
Thanks for understanding. This is all I'm here to do, and I don't want to mess it up.
No, I understand.
I know I'm probably the last person you'd expect to be a guard. Or an escort, for that matter.
It's dangerous for you.
You shouldn't be here, Tim. This place is dangerous. Especially for someone like you.
It's not like that. Whatever you may think of him, he doesn't treat me like some broken little kid. I think he gets what it's like. He gave me a job. And I'm lucky to have it. This is the only option I've got. Just keep that in mind, maybe? Because if you and the boss go up against each other, the rest of Fabletown is going to get caught in the middle.
Don't you realize you're not just minding the door? You work for that crooked bastard, your hands get dirty too.
It's not so bad.
Not so bad? Are you fucking blind, Tim? He's a murderer.
So you're telling me you agree with everything Crane does?
What? I'll murder him too.
A lot of us depend on him. Some of us never get to the front of the line at the business office. But he's there. We need you, but we need him too. What we don't need him.
A
war. Hey, Sheriff, hold up. I gotta go in with you.
I don't have time for this.
God bless us, everyone.
You doing puff of smoke? Look like you're gonna pull something out of your pocket. No, never mind.
Why some kind of fucking joke to you? What did I tell you, eh? Stop laughing at me.
What the fuck? Holy shit!
Hiya. How you doing? Wait. I wasn't expecting to see you two there. Whew. Yeah, you might want to go heal up that horn that I ripped off.
I was wondering when you'd turn up. You know, Tim would have been happy to have let you in.
I'm so sorry, sir. He wouldn't
wait. It's all right, Tim. I shouldn't have expected the sheriff to give you respect enough to do your job. But you did fine. You can go now.
Bye, Tim.
You see, everyone in Fabletown has a role to fill. You just have to pay attention to what they need to help them find it.
Why don't you
have a seat, Sheriff? We have a great deal to discuss.
Smoke. It's kind of weird how he does that. That was nice. What happened? Did it break or? Oh no! You let why? That's a huge cliffhanger.
I've heard stories about you.
Oh no, we're gonna run into Bloody Mary
again. In the old days, how you picked off those men one by one. Oh, how they screamed. The wolf is coming. And they would wait, hiding anywhere they could squeeze their pathetic, shivering corpses. Some would just drop to their knees where they stood, close their eyes, and wait for death.
Hmm.
And you'd give it to them. I wish I could have seen it. Oh well.
Ooh, stuff is gonna get frosty next episode. It's gonna get badass. Oh, you and 30.9% of players chose not to give Colin an answer. I had to do that. You and 62% of the players did not try to remove the ribbon. You and 51.7% of the players went to Lucky's Pawns first. I feel like I needed to do that first. You and 50.7% of players decided Toad should not go to the farm. Well, I don't think he should have. How did you respond to the Crooked Man? You and 29.1% of players lit a cigarette. Yep, that's how you ended. Yep. Well, guys, next episode is going to be really awesome. So stick around for that. Anyways, guys, thank you for watching so much for this video. If you liked it, go ahead and hit that like button. If you want more content, hit that subscribe button. And like always, I'll see y'all later. Have a good night.